Are you interested how to professionally develop microservices in Node.js? Then welcome to this video series. Here I will show you a step-by-step process how to develop a simple data microservice. We will start with setting up project structure, implementing persistence, business logic, exposing external RESTful interface for the external consumers, and then we will finish it by wrapping this microservice into a process container. To work with the code, you will need to install Node.js on your computer and Docker. All other dependencies will run inside the Docker. For this sample, we will use a simple scenario. Let's say someone installed Bluetooth beacons around the building and recorded their positions. Then you walk around this building and run in on your mobile device an application that detects emitted signals from those beacons and triangulate your position. Our data microservice will store positions of those beacons in the database, and it will implement a business logic to triangulate your position. We will implement this microservice as a collection of loosely coupled components. We will have persistence components that will store data in the database or other types of persistent storages. We'll have controller that will implement business logic, service that will expose that functionality through RESTful interface to outside consumers, and we will package all the components into a process container to run it as a system process. To write this microservice, we will use PipServices Polyglot Microservices Toolkit. The cool thing about this technology that allows you to implement microservices using different languages and then deploy them across a variety of platforms. Most of other technologies out there allows you either implement microservices in one language and then deploy them on different platforms, or target specific platform and write code in different languages. The good thing about PipServices is that allows you to do both. You can write code in different languages and then you can package it and run it as a system process, as a Docker container, as Lambda function, as Service Fabric service, or any other technology that may become available in the future. The source code is available on GitHub at github.com/pip-services-samples/service-beacons-node.x. Let's start with creating a project structure. First, create a folder on your disk and give it any name. I choose to give it the same name as the name of the component in the repository. Then, inside that folder, create several subfolders. You'll need bin, config, data, docker, src, and test. Then you'll need to create a package JSON that will specify a configuration for Node.js project. We will give the project a name, service beacons Node.x version 1.0. Then we'll define entry point for the code, which will be in the object folder src index.js, and entry point for TypeScript typings in object src index.dts. We will use test script as a shortcut to run tests using mockup. Then you will need to add a few dependencies from PipServices toolkit. We will use comments module, components, container, data, MongoDB for persistence, RPC for RESTful interfaces, and Swagger. And then we can add a few dev dependencies, typings for Chai, Mocha, and Node, and Chai and Mocha frameworks for our unit tests. The second file you'll need to create in the root folder is called tsconfig.json. This file will be used by TypeScript compiler. We will specify target as ECMAScript 6, output folder as object folder, root directory is the root. Then we will turn on source maps to allow debugger in to walk through TypeScript code. And then we will include node modules and object folders from the compilation. In the next video, we will implement persistent components and write automated tests for them. Thank you.